What if somewhere in the cosmos, another Earth is waiting? Not a dream, not a theory, but a real twin, with oceans, clouds, rain, and maybe even life. Tonight we dive deep into everything great about Earth's twin. Welcome to a journey that will change the way you look at the universe forever. Our story begins with humanity building new eyes, telescopes of immense power sent to stare into the void. Kepler, TESS, their mission, to hunt for planets beyond our solar system, and the James Webb Space Telescope, designed to peer deeper and with more clarity than ever before. They watched, unblinking, for a telltale sign, a tiny periodic dip in a star's brightness, a shadow passing in front of a distant sun. For years, they found gas giants and barren super-Earths, but then, one signal, from a star much like our own, was different. As data from different telescopes confirmed the finding, a quiet realization dawned. This one, this planet, could be our mirror. The mystery deepened as the parameters aligned. Its size was a near-perfect match to Earth's. Its orbit placed it in the Goldilocks zone, where the temperature could allow for liquid water. Distance, orbit, temperature, all matching Earth beautifully. The sketch of a second home was beginning to form. So why do we call it Earth's twin? The evidence is a portrait of breathtaking similarity. First, its size. It's a rocky world, almost identical in diameter to our own. Its temperature range, thanks to its perfect orbit, mirrors ours, making it neither a frozen wasteland nor a scorched desert. This temperate climate means it could have the single most important ingredient for life: liquid water. Its gravity is strong enough to hold a substantial atmosphere, potentially rich in nitrogen, hydrogen, or carbon dioxide, with clouds of water vapor floating above its oceans. Like Earth, it likely has seasons, dawns, and sunsets, painting its alien sky with familiar colors. And its molten core likely generates a magnetic field, an invisible shield protecting the planet from harmful cosmic radiation. It's not just a planet. It's a story of possibility. Water worlds are the perfect cradles for life. On Earth, life began in the ocean, and on a twin world, the same could be true. Its oceans would act as a planetary thermostat, absorbing heat from its star and circulating it around the globe, preventing extreme temperatures. These great currents regulate the climate, ensuring stability over millions of years, giving life a chance to evolve. Tides, pulled by a distant moon, would shape the planet, creating rich intertidal zones where life could make the leap from sea to land. Waves would churn the surface, mixing oxygen from the air into the water, shaping coastlines and energizing the biosphere. There is a poetic idea in this, that another ocean, light years away, is breathing with us, a silent, rhythmic connection across the void. To truly understand Earth's twin, scientists must read its air. They study the atmospheric signatures, the chemical fingerprints left in starlight. When starlight filters through the atmosphere, gases absorb specific colors. This creates a unique barcode that tells us what the air is made of. They search for biosignatures, gases like methane or dimethyl sulfide, which on Earth are overwhelmingly produced by life. Even the simple discovery of clouds on a twin world is revolutionary. It proves the existence of a water cycle, evaporation, condensation, and rain. It transforms the planet from a static rock into a dynamic, living weather system, capable of distributing water and regulating temperature. Finding a combination of these gases, oxygen, methane, and water vapor, could be the first real, undeniable sign of life beyond Earth. Life does not need to look like us. Life adapts. Life transforms. Life finds a way. On Ethel, life could be microbial, forming the foundation of the biosphere. Or it could be complex oceanic life, evolving in a world of different chemistry. There could be complex life forms on land, with unique anatomies and senses we can barely imagine. Another Earth means another evolution of intelligence is possible. a second genesis, a second story of consciousness waking up to the cosmos. This is the deep emotional heart of the search. The ultimate question follows. What if humans could live there? Could Earth's twin be a backup home for humanity? The answer depends on the path we choose. Terraforming the world to suit us, or adapting to a world that is naturally habitable. We would have to contend with differences in gravity, which affect our bodies over generations, and adapt to different day-night cycles, which would challenge our natural circadian rhythms. The atmosphere, even if breathable, could contain microbes or allergens our immune systems have never encountered. The journey itself would be the greatest challenge, requiring future interstellar travel technologies we can only dream of today. But the dream of a second cradle, a place to ensure the long-term survival of human consciousness, is a powerful motivator. Earth's twin could be a new beginning, a second chance for humanity to write its future among the stars. Knowing we are not alone changes everything. The discovery of a twin world expands human consciousness, affecting our faith, our science, and our philosophy. It forces us to see ourselves not as the center of the story, but as one chapter in a much larger cosmic book. For so long, we have felt a profound cosmic loneliness. The idea of a twin world shatters that isolation, giving humanity a sense of kinship on a galactic scale. It gives us a grand, unifying project to strive for and makes humanity dream again. So how does James Webb actually see this distant world? It uses a technique of almost unbelievable precision. It waits for the planet to pass in front of its star, and then it analyzes the tiny fraction of starlight that filters through its atmosphere. This light is broken down into a spectrum, a chemical barcode that reveals the gases present in the air of another world. It searches for the telltale signatures of water, of clouds, and even of life itself. The precision is so high, it's like watching a shadow pass behind a candle. From billions of miles away, this is not sci-fi. This is happening right now. Two worlds, two stories, one destiny. Maybe Earth's twin is not just another planet. Maybe it's a message, a reminder, that the universe creates balance, that every darkness has a light, that every lonely world has a companion. If a second Earth exists out there, it means hope exists everywhere. It means tomorrow is bigger than our fears. It means humanity has a future written among the stars. So keep looking up, keep believing, keep dreaming. Because the universe is not finished surprising us, and neither is your life. Thanks for watching. I'm Dunet Cherimond. Welcome to Heavens and Beyond.